two out and then...
Maybe you pull one and I pull the other?
Nah, we'll just alternate.
Okay.
No, you pull them out and then you go first.
I love my
hands,
even all the dirty talk.
It's okay.
That's my favorite. It's please by yourself.
Happy Indulgence, and I'm here today with Jay Christoph, and today we're going to be doing a special edition of Rip It or Ship It with characters from Jay's books. So we're going to be grabbing names.
Could be disastrous, just never
go. That's alright, that's what everything's for. Alright, so we're going to be grabbing names off this bag, and then, yeah, let's begin.
Alright, so
grab two.
I have two, wow,
alright.
So Jackson, who was... in Gemini?
Yeah. Gemini.
Yes.
Yep.
I got that right.
Jackson,
I did get it right.
Eric.
Jackson and Ashlyn.
No,
I don't think that would work out for anyone in the
no.
world.
No. That's a very bitchy couple.
Yeah. It's hard to talk about without getting into spoilers for Gemini, but
no, I don't
think that would... Also, spoilers for Nevernight as well. But I can't see that working out in any way, shape, or form.
Nah. Agreed.
Sorry,
Jess. So that's a rip.
You lose. A rip?
Yeah, a rip.
No. Now we're littering in the library.
We have to pick it up. So we've got Eve and Eclipse.
Yeah, I think that works.
I think so, because she's got Kaiser.
Eve has Kaiser. Kaiser is a robot dog, and Eclipse is a shadow wolf, so yeah.
There you go.
I imagine it would be pretty freaky for Eve and probably for Eclipse as well, being surrounded by shadow demons and robots and computer technology, given where they come from. But yeah, I can totally see that working.
I think so. That's a winner.
Cricket and How. So Cricket is a character in life, like he's kind of the robotic conscience of the main character. And Hannah's a character in Gemini. She's kind of a martial artist / tactician.
I feel like she would punch him in the face.
She would punch him pretty quick.
Yeah.
Cricket's whole thing is that he's programmed to worry about you. He's like a carer bot. He's supposed to advise you when you're doing something stupid or rash.
Yeah.
And Hannah doesn't really do stupid things, but she does a lot
no.
of things that get her into danger. So I imagine they would probably team up and she would figure out a way to very quickly leave
get
him
rid
back
of him.
At base while she went and did what needed to be done.
Yeah, agreed.
So maybe that's like half a rip?
Maybe. Rip one.
Rip
one.
Alright.
Yeah, okay.
$10.
So we've got Leona from
God's Grave, yeah.
And Furion.
Well, yeah. Yeah.
They're already together.
Yeah.
There you go.
I mean, it didn't end great, but yes.
No spoilers.
Definitely be together, yeah.
Yeah. Cool. Next one. That was easy.
I'm not sure itself. Trick from Nevernight and Reese. From Obsidio. I don't see...
No.
Pretty sure Trick would be open to it. I mean, everyone kind of got taught in the red shirts the means by which to seduce members of the opposite sex. Sometimes
Reese
that
would
be necessary. But Reese does not strike me
I don't
as
think
adventurous.
So. No.
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 I think we'd rip that.
Yeah, I think so. Let's rip that.
Sorry, Reese, you're lost, man.
Alright. Alright, so we have Ezra and Nick.
I mean, the kind of buddy cop thing in Obsidio, right? I mean, they fly the same plane. That's kind of Top Gun-esque. You could be my wingman anytime.
Alright, so can we talk about, like, if there was no Katie or Hannah?
Would they ever be, like, a thing, or, like,
no.
buddies?
Buddies, yes. Thing, no. That'd be way too much testosterone.
Yeah, and Nick's a smoker. I don't think Ezra would go in for a smoker, quite frankly.
No.
That would probably be the break point in their relationship.
There you go. Nick will feel intimidated by Ezra's muscles.
You think? Maybe. I imagine them both as reasonably muscular, but yeah, Ezra's
but
a bigger job.
Smaller.
Yeah, Ezra's bigger and all kind right. of football jockey.
Do you want to do the honours?
Yeah, sorry. Yeah, you lost, Ezra.
Alright, is it your go?
I think it is.
Okay.
So Katie, who's the character from Illuminate, and Preacher, who is the villain from Lifelike. I don't see that working out too good for anyone.
No way. Nah.
I mean, he's kind of mostly metal to begin with. I'm not entirely sure he's functional in
yeah.
that respect.
I kind of
one would hope, but
no.
I haven't really put
thanks for
story.
Answering.
And he's also a pretty bad guy, and Katie's
yeah.
a pretty good-natured
She's
person.
Pure. There'll be some pretty great banter, but it's not going to work.
Yeah, yeah.
So.
There'll be some
no.
sass, but no
yeah.
sparks.
No.
No. Man, we're ripping
That's
a lot.
There you
no
go.
One in my world's getting along with it. Kind of depressing.
So I've got Lemon Fresh and Aiden. Oh my gosh, yes!
Yeah, I can totally
yeah,
see
that. Yeah, totally.
Yep, I mean... Yeah, in some respects, Lemon is kind of similar to Ella from Gemini.
I see that now.
And yeah, Ella gets along with Aiden pretty well. Like, Lemon is probably a nicer person. She's a little less ruthless than Ella is, but yeah, they could team up.
Yeah,
totally.
Definitely.
And if, you know, Aiden never got out of hand, Lemon could just deal with things.
Yeah, as he does. Three that work.
Yeah.
There you go.
Alright, Ezekiel, who is the main male character from Lifelike,
and
Ella.
I feel like Ella would be like, dude, you take yourself too seriously.
Yeah, he does take himself seriously. I mean, he's a machine, so Ella's kind of a computer with...
Oh,
maybe
interesting.
She could, like, fix his personality defects, of which there are many.
Interesting.
And maybe just get him to... chill out and calm down a little bit.
Maybe.
I think it'll work.
Yeah?
I'm going to go with ship. Like, maybe not romantically, but I think they could work together in some kind of body cop duo-esque relationship.
Okay.
You're not
going to... My ones are ripped. So.
Ripped? All right.
So we rip one.
Rip
no,
one.
You would keep one. Yeah.
We'll rip Zeke. I can't rip
okay.
Ella.
There you go. Got half. We have one that we disagreed on. So.
All right.
Yeah. All right.
Those,
so I've got Jessamy
yep.
from Nevernight and Mercurio.
I mean, they deal with each other in the book and they're not particularly fond of each other, so I'm going to say no.
No.
I think that's a definite.
Consensus rip.
Yeah. Given what's happening in Dark Thorn at the moment, yeah.
Oh my so gosh. No spoilers.
No spoilers, no. So Asha from Obsidio and Gabriel from Lifelike. Gabriel is another one of the villains from Lifelike.
Maybe because Reese is also kind of.
I mean, aesthetically, Asha would probably be into him, but
yeah.
he thinks of human beings as insects, so
okay.
probably wouldn't be a sustainable relationship.
Okay. So it might be like a quick fling thing, but.
Yeah,
no.
And would very quickly
dissipate.
Go somewhere bad.
Okay.
Yeah. I think
let's rip that. All right. I have Mr. Kindly and Cassius from...
All right, both from Nevernight.
Yeah.
No, I don't think so. I mean, the demons in Nevernight, they reflect your personality. So Mr. Kindly is a kind of a reflection of Mia's personality, which is why Eclipse...
There you go.
And Eclipse and Mr. Kindly do not get along, and Eclipse is a reflection of Cassius' personality. So
okay.
I think they would... not get along at all.
Alright, that is a rip.
Rip. Sorry, Cass.
And I have one more. There you go. So lucky last.
Lucky last. Alright. So you have Mia from Nevernight. Really? Yeah, I think that'd work.
I think so.
Was that a plant? Was that orchestrated?
It might have been.
Maybe.
It might have been.
Maybe. I think that
definitely.
Would probably work
yeah.
out.
That's probably the like OTP of all time.
I'm not sure it would be sustainable because she smokes again and like smoking's pretty bad for you.
Yes, don't smoke at home, guys.
Yeah, especially not in bed. But yes, I think it will work out.
Okay. There you go. Awesome. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you did, please give us a thumbs up. And yeah, subscribe if you want to see more. Thanks, guys.